Beacon has been going to the Gambia for over 25 years now. It has been amazing to be part of this history and to make a mark on the lives of so many Gambian communities.
Today this could be the greatest day of our lives. Before it all ends, before we run out of time.
My favourite part would have to be interacting with the locals. Everyone's really friendly, especially our student guide Musa, getting to know him a week.
Tonight this could be the greatest night of our lives. Let's make a new start. The future is ours to find. Can you see it? Can you see it?
I think in my teaching career I've been on about 20 residential trips altogether. I think this is the most inspiring and educationally valuable of the ones I've been on. I've been particularly impressed with how the Beacon students have come out of the wealthy culture of Sussex, have come into an area where they've seen abject poverty in the villages and responded remarkably in the way that they mixed in with the Gambian children and adults, the sort of spirit that they've shown, and also the very professional way in which they've gone about thinking about how the aid can be best distributed for the greater good of the local community.
Today this could be the greatest day of our lives.
So, Mr. Baker, what has been your favourite part of your week in the Gambia?
It's always the bait. The bait's amazing, but actually another thing for me was the villages. This year I went to the new village in Mbutu, and that they've never had us go before them.
We are building some really basic but fundamental infrastructure in these communities. We're paying for healthcare, we're paying for medicine, we're paying for school rooms, we're paying for water pumps, we're paying for beds in hospitals, we're paying for, you know, nurses to get trained and people to go to university. These fundamental things are the key sort of building blocks of a society, and we get to provide those.